All right, pumpkins appear to be in season. Like out here, the Cullum sixth graders get a chance to visit Gene Hansen's pumpkin patch. A great day for kids. And this time of year is just fun to get out and see. And you can even feel the change in the air. Thanks again for sharing, Gene. Here's a look at that sun setting on our day. Still clouds in the FM area. Traffic moving along quite fine. And 64 degrees, not too far from our high of 67. Today, gusting winds up to around 20 miles per hour. They're from a south-southeasterly direction. 11-mile-per-hour wind with the gusty nature of that wind settling down a bit for now in Grand Forks. It's 63 and quite a bit of cloudiness there as well. We see cooler temperatures where we have these green isotherms, and we have temperatures in the mid-50s for Devil's Lake, Langdon at 59, and low 60s for Jamestown and Valley City. Low 60s as well in Lakes Country, and as we mentioned earlier, it was a warm one in Roseau today. The warm spot of our region at 70 degrees, now 66. Here is a look at that radar. We see this band of moisture, one of which is making its way into the FM area, but as the SkyCam showed, there is not much moisture making its way out of the bottom of those clouds. So most of us will stay dry. I cannot rule out one or two spots that get a spit of rain, but that will be about all it amounts to. The heavier showers are moving through Ramsey, Benson County, the Madoc area, and these are not moving anywhere fast, so the rainfall totals likely adding up quite quickly in these spots, with rain lasting for over 2 hours. And we could see some spots with a good couple of inches of rain. Speaking of rainfall totals, as we take a look throughout the day, not much of the overnight last night, early hours today had rain in northeast North Dakota, where we see these yellows and oranges. Radar estimates of rain in Cavalier and Pembina counties, upwards of 2.5 inches and a good inch up here by Rock Lake as well. So certainly some abundant moisture with these cells. A few clouds out here, clear skies in Minnesota. And it does look like we have some change heading our way. Speaking of change, a lot of folks listening with the attention drawn to Joaquin, Hurricane Category 4, but more models are starting to suggest it stays out over the Atlantic. Still have some models disagreeing, and that's the case when we're talking about several days out here with what models are showing landfall in the mid-Atlantic states would be sometime late Sunday. So we'll keep you posted on that, with a lot of eyes watching. Tonight, look at the clouds clear out, the rain showers end, and they stay out to the west. Temperatures falling quickest overnight out to the far east. We'll be in the 30s, and yes, we could see some frost out there again. 40s to start the day in the Red River Valley. It'll be a cool start, but the winds will actually help to stir things up and keep us from getting too cold here in the east. All the clouds stay out to the east. Midday on your Friday, temperatures only rising into the mid-50s to near 60, and again, just like yesterday, we're going to stay in the 60s, more sun out east, and temperatures will be in that 60 to 65 degree range for almost everybody. Friday night football looks quiet, clear, and it does look like we'll have conditions with more winds from the southeast again. Frost advisory, far eastern Minnesota, northern Wisconsin. Your planning forecast. Rise and shine on Friday, 41 degrees. South winds picking up through the midday, 15 to 25 miles per hour. Temperatures rising out of the 50s in the afternoon to the low to mid 60s is all we'll see. A lot of low to mid 60s across the valley, but we will not have as much in the way of rain, and the best chance of cloudiness will be out to the far western counties. Gorgeous shot shared by Michaela. Thank you, Michaela. This is near Kindred, and your 7-day planner shows quiet weather again on Saturday. Big Bison game in South Dakota. Temperatures there will be very similar, in the 60s for game time, cooling into the 50s. Sunday, well, pleasant. More of the same into next week, but more unsettled, with a better chance of scattered showers Monday and again on Thursday.
All right, big touch.
You're welcome.
Later in sports, it's not just a trophy. Hear from the current Bison about what the Dakota marker means to them.
And up next, plenty of reasons to take pride in North Dakota.